We are going to build this habit tracker in Notion, which is a free tool. After building this habit tracker, all you need to do is fill 2 to 3 fields for each habit, and the rest will be automatically updated. And all of the tools which you are going to use, even the charts, are free tools, so don't worry about this as well. So first of all, I should create a page. So I click on here, add a page, and then I can name it. For example, let's say my habit tracker, and let's add an icon. For example, I want to use this one. Then here I should click on this empty page, and here I simply type a slash and table, and you can see it says database and table view, so I click on it. And I want to create a new database, so I should click on this. And as you can see, this is the title, which I don't want that, so I should click on this. And I should go to layout, and I don't want to show the database title. And I close this. And as you can see, the name of this view is table, but I want to change it, so I right click on it and I press rename. And for example, I want to choose all, and that's it. I pressed enter and I click away. That's it. And you can see we have a view which is called all. I mean, all of our habits are going to be shown here. Then I want to add another view for my reading habit, for example. So I click on this plus button, and here it says, what kind of view do you want? I want, again, a new table. So I click on it, and again, I don't want to show the title. So I click on this and I close this, and let's rename this once again, and I want to call it reading habit. Plus enter, click away. Okay, now you can see that we have a column called name, and I want to rename this column, so I click on it. And for example, I want to name it index, I mean the number of day. For example, day number 1, day number 2, day number 3, day number 4, and so on. So for example, let's add a couple of data. For example, this is day number 1, day number 2, and so on. And also, we don't need this tags column, so I want to delete this column. So I right click on it and I press delete property, and I press delete. Okay, now let's make this column a little bit smaller. And now let's add another column, so I click on this plus button. First of all, I should define the type. So this column is going to be a date, so I click on this, and the name is going to be, for example, date. That's it. And I press enter and I click away, and let's fill this column with some dates. That's it. And let's make this column a little bit smaller. But now I want to create a column like this, I mean this habit column, and the type of this column is select. For example, if I click on it, you can see I can select one of these options. You can see the first option is reading and the other one is exercising. And maybe you ask, what is the benefit of adding this column? For example, if I go to the all view, you can see that we have a column which is called habit, and it specifies whether this habit, whether these entries, whether these numbers are for exercising habit or for reading habit. So here I click on this plus icon, and I'm going to add a column. So the type of that column is going to be select, and the name of that column is going to be habit. And we can add some options. You want to have only 2 habits, reading and exercising. So the first option is going to be reading. I pressed enter, and you can see this option has been added. Let's add another option, exercising. And once again, I press enter, and you can see we have added these 2 options. And also, I want to set the color of all options to be gray, and you will see why in the calendar view, which we are going to create later. So I click on this, and I want to choose gray. So you can see all of the options are gray. So I close this, and you can see we have a column which is called habit. So this is reading, so I should choose reading for all of these. But now I want to create this minutes column in order to see how many minutes I spend on each habit. So here I click on this plus icon, and the type of this column is going to be number, and the name of this column is going to be minutes. And I press enter and I click away, and let's make this column a little bit smaller, and let's fill this column with some numbers. For tracking the habits, personally I use this system, and for explaining it, let's take reading as an example. First of all, we need some levels and also some alternatives for our reading habits, and we need these levels for future steps as well. I suggest defining 5 levels for your reading habit: the show up level, the easy level, the medium level, the hard level, and the hero level. For example, reading 1 sentence from the book or the reading app can be a good choice for the show up level. And reading for 2 minutes, 10 minutes, 30 minutes, and 60 minutes can be a good definition for easy, medium, hard, and hero levels. And I suggest tracking your habits using these notations and symbols. But now I want to create this column, which you can see it determines whether I have done the show up version, whether I have done the easy version, medium version, hard version, or the hero version. So now let's click on this plus icon. The type of this column is going to be select. And for example, let's choose a name for this column. For example, level. And let's add some options. So the first option is going to be a cross, I mean the show up version. So in order to add the cross on Windows, you should click on Windows and the dot in order to see this emojis. To be honest, I don't know what you should do on Mac in order to see these emojis, but I will put these symbols in the description so you can use them and you can copy and paste those symbols in these fields. So now press enter and let's add another option. And once again, I should press enter. But now I want to change the order of these options. So I click on this and I drag it to the top. And I want to change the colors. The first one, I mean, the show up is going to be red. The next one is going to be orange. The next one is going to be yellow. The next one is going to be blue. And the last one is going to be green. That said, you can see we have our levels. And you can see here's the level column. And now based on our definitions for each level, we are going to fill this column. And also for our reading habit, you want to add another column for tracking how many pages we read on each day. So I click on this plus icon. And the type of this column is going to be number, and the name is going to be pages, and I press enter and I click away, and let's fill this column with some numbers. That's it. And if I go to all view, you can see we have all of these data as well. You can see we have all of these columns. But now let's add another view for our exercising habit. So here I press on this plus icon in order to add another column for exercising habit. So again, it's going to be a table view and the name is going to be exercising. And I don't want the titles, so I turn this off and I press close. And as you can see in our exercising habit, we have these data which is related to reading habit, but don't worry, we are going to fix it. And in order to fix this, you should move your cursor here and you can see the filter button. So you should click on it. And for this view, we are going to filter the habits which are exercising. That's it. And let's click away. And now you can see we don't see those data related to reading habits. And let's do the same thing for reading habits as well. So here, once again, I click on this filter button and I'm going to filter those habits which are reading. That's it. And once again, let's click away and let's go to exercising view and let's add some data. For example, this is day number one. This is the date. And I should click away. This is exercising habits. And for example, here I want to change the order and I want to put this column before the level column. So in order to do so, I click on this three dots and I drag this above the level and I click away. And you can see we have this column before the level column. And now based on our definition for each level, we should fill this column as well. So it's very obvious that we are not going to fill this column for our exercising habit, but let's add another column. And the type of this column is going to be text. And let's name this details. And let's close this. And now we can add some details for each day in order to see what we have done for our exercising habits. So that's it. And in order to fix this display issue, let's click on this three dots and let's turn the full width option. And also let's add a cover. So I click on this and it randomly chooses a cover for this page and we can change it. So if I click on this, for example, let's choose another cover. For example, I want this one. So I click on it and that's it. So now if I go to all view, and by the way, let's make these columns a little bit smaller. And also let's change the order because I want to put this column at the end. So I click on this three dots. And let's move minutes above the level. That's it. So I close this. And now we can see we have all of our habits in one place. But now let's add another view, I mean the calendar view, in order to see all of these stuff in a calendar. So in order to do so, I click on this plus button. But the type of this view is going to be the calendar view. And let's close this. By the way, I don't want to show the title, so I turn this off. And I close this and I'm going to change the data which are going to be shown in each cell. So I click on this three dots and first of all I want to show the habit in each cell. So I click on this. Also I want to see the level and the number of minutes. So now let's close this. And as you can see in this calendar view we have a couple of things. The first one is basically the index column, I mean day number one, day number two, and so on. The second one is the habit. The third one is the level. And the fourth one is the number of minutes I've spent for that habit. So now we want to add some charts, but before that I should split the page into two parts. So I should click here after the title of this page and I press enter. And here I simply type data. I mean this part is the data part. And I click on this and I want to turn this block to heading 1 and also want to change the color to gray. So this is the first part, I mean our data. But now here you want to add another part for our dashboard, I mean for our charts. And I want to turn this block into heading 1. And once again, while my cursor is here at the end of this line, I press enter. And my dashboard is going to have three parts. The first part is the overall in order to track our overall progress. The second part is going to be reading. The next one is going to be exercising. And as you can see, we are going to put reading and exercising beside each other. So in order to do so, I should drag this and I want to move here, I mean beside reading. So you can see we have two columns, reading and exercising. And let's change this into header 2, so turn into header 2. And also let's change the color to blue. So that's it, and now we need to add our charts. So for doing so, first of all, you should go to Google and search for Notion charts, and you can see here is a website, notioncharts.io. So I open this website. So first of all, I should sign up, so I click on this, and I want to sign up with email. And after filling these fields, I press create account, and I should verify my email using the code which they have emailed me, and I press confirm. So that's it, but now I should connect this website to my Notion. So I click on this, connect Notion. So in this step, Notion asks us to select some pages which you want to give access to that website. So I click on this, and I should specify those pages. In this example is my habit tracker, so I click on it, and I should press on allow access. So after seeing this, I should refresh, and you can see the setup was successful. So I want to create some charts, so I click on this. So first of all, we should choose the database. So if I click on this, you can see we have only one database, which is called Untitled, because if you remember, we didn't use any title for our database. So I click on this. So for the first chart, the x-axis is going to be date, and for date format I personally use this one, which for example it is April 1, 2023, so I prefer this one, so I choose this one. And for the y-axis we want to have the minutes, and then we are going to sort based on the date. So you can see the x-axis is sorted by date. And let's change the title, so this is going to be overall, and I should click on this check mark, so you can see the title has been changed. And here I simply copy the embed URL, and now I should go to my Notion page. So now I put my cursor here at the end of this line, and I press enter, and here I simply type dash embed, and I click on this, and here I paste that URL, and I click on this embed link. We are still waiting. And there it is. You can see we have the overall chart. But now let's add the reading and exercising chart, which they are a little bit different, and we should add some filters. So let's go to Notion charts, and here I simply click on back to dashboards. And here we can see that we have one chart, and it says that you have 4 charts left. It means that in the free version, you can have up to 5 charts, which is enough, I think. So once again, I click on this, create chart. So the first step is doing the same thing, so I'm going to fast forward. But the second step is to add some filters in order to tell Notion charts that this chart should be only for reading habits. So in order to do so, we should add some filters. So I click on this data filters, and here I should add a filter, and the filter is this, the habit. You can see the habit should be equal to reading, and I should click on this save and apply filter, and I close it. And now let's change the title to reading habits, and I should press this check mark, and you can see the title has been changed. So I should copy the embed URL, and here in Notion I press enter, and here I simply type embed, paste this, and I embed link. And you can see we have the chart for our reading habits. We are going to do the same thing for our exercising habits, so I'm not going to waste your time, and I'm going to fast forward. So we can see we have added the exercising habit as well. But now let's add some charts like these, I mean pie charts. So for doing so, first of all, I should create a chart. I should choose a database, and the x-axis is going to be levels. The y-axis is going to be again levels, and we should group by the count. And here we should change the chart type to pie chart. And again, this chart is overall, so if you want to have just the reading habit, so you should add some filters. And I want to add a title, and I copy the URL, and I simply add it to Notion. And we can do the exact process for our exercising habit, and I'm not going to waste your time, and I'm going to fast forward. But we want to put these charts beside each other, so it's very easy. I can drag this chart and put it beside this one. So now you can see we have built our dashboard as well, and those charts are dynamic. I mean, for example, if you change something in the data section, those charts are going to be updated. Please like the video because it really helps the channel.